Medic 410, good morning. 203-108. 42 from St. Mary's.
Paramedics are on the way. Just don't let her have anything to eat or drink. My maker's sick or cause problems for the doctor.
Medic 142, able to go 108 for a call down the street at the Arlington Towers, 142. Medic 142, party 3, back pain, 10-4.
Every single call we go on has a potential to be different.
You always have to be ready. You have to be prepared for what can go wrong. And you have to be able to do that when you just got out of bed. You know, we get called in the middle of the night. We get up at 3 a.m. and I have to be on my toes at 3 a.m.
You have to be strong. And you got to know what you're doing. You get tested here.
You have to be compassionate. You have to care. You have to know how to speak to people.
To have that one-on-one connection where you're building up trust and honesty with another human being, critical.
I wanted to be like those guys on TV who saved everybody. I knew I wanted to be in the healthcare field.
About 6 or 7 years back, my grandfather, he was at a hospital here and he had open heart surgery. And he had a male nurse taking care of him. He was fantastic. The knowledge that he had and the, you know, just the strength in his job, it really turned me on to, you know, this profession.
Oh, there's so many reasons why I wanted to choose this field. One of the reasons why is because when I was younger, I always took care of my teeth. I feel like if I could help someone improve their smile, it would be a lot better. That would make me feel good.
The best thing about healthcare is the variety. There is so much out there. There is so many avenues that a student, an individual, male or female, can take. And what's so nice about it is in healthcare, if you're in the hospital, there are so many incremental steps that you can take along the way.
Yeah, it was actually an experience when I first started here, just because I had never been in a hospital job before. Monitor Tech keeps an eye on the patient's heart rhythms. It does get busy sometimes, that's for sure. But we all help each other out, so.
Fantastic to be an RN because there's multiple avenues to take. Everywhere, emergency department, education, administrative stuff.
There's so many different areas of nursing that you can go into that you find where you can really play your strengths. You know, there are nurses that are just so good with families and patients and the emotional aspect, and they end up in a different area than necessarily the nurses who are in there to get you taken care of in the moment. So, you know, you can really find your niche as far as any of the healthcare jobs go.
Is when the patients come in and whether they're having, we're just going to look at their heart and see what's going on with their arteries, or they're having a heart attack. We bring them in and we get them on the table and we prep them, get them ready for the procedure.
We range from nursing staff to clerical staff to radiology staff to, I mean, the physicians as well. I mean, there's a lot of people involved. I mean, all the way up to scheduling the patient, all the way down to discharging the patients.
I went through 2 years of college and went through the x-ray program itself. I graduated in Pasadena, California. I always wanted to move to the Cal Fire because there's always a sense of team. There's three people on a team. You never felt like you're left alone. And it was an exciting job and it paid a lot of money.
Currently, I'm working for Circle of Life Hospice. Being able to provide that end of life honesty and trust and pain-free environment in the home is I can't tell you how incredible that is.
Rem's a dispatch, Matt. As a medical dispatcher, we're answering 911 phone calls. It's an awesome career field. I've been in it since I got out of high school. You don't have to have a, you know, master's degree or a bachelor's degree. You can be out of high school, go get your EMT advanced or your paramedic and go help people and make a difference.
Probably one of the most exciting things for me is the puzzle that you're given every single time. So even if you're presented with a patient that has the same sickness, they may be presenting in different ways, and so you get to try to figure out what's going wrong with them. You can see anything from delivering a child to helping somebody with a cut on their hand, doing CPR on a patient, to ultimately, as dark as it may seem, maybe even a dead person. So someone that we ultimately can't bring back and can't take to the hospital.
I give a lot of people confidence in what they can do after they've gone through a pretty traumatic either surgery or an accident. It's one of the best things for me is somebody comes in and they tell me, yeah, I went back out there and I did exactly what I was doing before. So that always keeps me going. I graduated from the University of Colorado at Boulder with a degree in integrative physiology. So a lot of science classes in college. It was mainly anatomy, physics, chemistry, math. A lot of the tough stuff, but it was definitely worth it.
Thinking about health careers, it's very, very competitive. It is critical that you get exposed to as much as you can, as early age as you can.
Well, when I was in high school, I was a part of one of the first groups to have an actual Health Careers Academy, which kind of allowed me to dive more into, you know, the medical field than I would have before. I had a unique opportunity back in 2009 when I was laid off to go back, you know, to school, and I knew exactly what I wanted to do. You know, I did my EMT class and spent time in the emergency room and worked with the nurses and absolutely fell in love with it. And it's something that was really important to me. You know, there's a lot of places that I've been on certain floors where most of the nurses I worked with were males.
The program is very competitive to get in. Now that I'm almost finished, I am very happy with the decision I made and I can't wait to start in the hospital. Just really excited.
There are enormous opportunities for high school students to stay in Nevada, become fully educated, and then ultimately gainfully employed in a career area of promise such as healthcare. Our community college programs are absolutely awesome. They're very, very technical, but the instruction is every bit the same as a university at those same level classes.
PMCC's Dental Assisting Program is the only program in Northern Nevada that is accredited by the Commission on Dental Accreditation. That means we're held to a higher standard. That means that our certification is actually recognized in the dental community here in Nevada and across the nation.
In dental assisting, math and science are very important, as well as critical thinking.
It's a lot of work, but it's so much fun. You get hands-on training with mannequins. You learn a lot of stuff. It's fast track, but the instructors are there to help you all the way.
Well, I've been an assistant for 16 years. I've been an instructor for 5 years. I was interested in the dental field and decided this would be a good step. So I started out here and ended up really liking it and just stuck with it.
When you start to look at career development, especially if you're in eighth grade going into ninth grade, ninth grade going into 10th grade, or 10th grade going into 11th grade, it doesn't matter. Career development is a process. And for some students, a unique view, they identify their career early on. But if you're like me, it took me a long time, a long process to identify a career path for myself. In career and technical education statewide, we have over 75 career pathway programs. Many, many schools include health sciences as a career pathway, and within the area of health sciences, there are 9 separate pathway programs that students can choose from.
I honestly, in middle school, I wanted to be a paleontologist. I wanted to dig for dinosaur bones. But then I started getting into some career and technical stuff here, and they told me, hey, there might not be a whole lot of money in that, so, you know, just you can keep it in mind, but feel out some other options and see what you like. So I tried welding, wasn't for me. I tried vet science, wasn't for me. Then I try sports medicine. I'm like, hey, you know, this is kind of sparks an interest. I really like it. Like, I'm on track to be a physical therapist or a physician's assistant. And through this class, I got to learn different taping jobs. I got to learn how to put patients in different positions so physicians can test on them.
The experience at AACT was actually going to the job shadow and going to Renown and looking at all the different fields that are at Renown and deciding which one I really want to go into. My future career plans are becoming a nurse. I feel like guy nurses are needed and they kind of look for guy nurses as well.
I'm involved in vet med. I love animals and I plan on becoming a vet.
Well, one thing they're going to gain is they're going to probably complete high school with a real focus. And many of our students who enroll in a pathway program have opportunities to earn post-secondary credit while they're in high school. So these areas often serve as a springboard to go into post-secondary education either at a community college level or university level.
Rem's a dispatch, Matt.
2-0-3-10-8.
I feel like the community needs us to be on top of the best and the newest and what's up and coming, that they rely on us to provide the best care that we possibly can.
I think because of the variety in healthcare right now and in the morphing of healthcare careers, it's more about the job and the task, and the gender part of it is becoming less of a factor.
I've worked with both male and female partners. I don't think anyone is any more or less capable. Again, I think that age, I think that exposure to world events, I think that your education and what you've learned about life in general and what you bring to this makes you a better care provider.
This is something that you can be passionate about your entire life.
When you join health careers, it only takes you in a better direction and you can learn so much, and it's just a great thing to do.
My parents were a huge influence. They always told me, Sahar, we see you making a difference. It was just so advanced, so wonderful for me to think about my future as an eighth grader. And okay. This is something you won't regret in 10 years. This is something you would want to share with your kids and your grandkids.
If you have the slightest interest in this, go ahead and take the shot, because you're going to be so shocked about everything you could learn. So many doors are opened. Your eyes see the world so differently. It's just a learning opportunity. Even if you don't choose a health career, it's stuff that sticks with you forever.